Welcome back to.
I just cannot anymore.
I just cannot. Tell me if I can.
I hope you guys enjoyed the fact that, you know, the pace was very fast, you know, to get things done at the start of these two. Because for the time being, the plot will kind of just stop
pretty much for a moment.
Yeah. Since the gathering is stranded, it's about to reach like a location where it's going to stay for a while. These couple of parts are going to be used mostly for the character to reflect upon themselves and organize one or two events. The problem is that on a pacing-wise, the plot essentially comes to switching halt.
You better not have caused Instructor Treep any trouble.
She's right there.
A.K.A. Quistis. Her name is Quistis Treep. So these are Treepy groupies, A.K.A. Quistis fangirls. Quistis has fangirls for whatever reason. Yeah.
Because she's an instructor.
I guess. You better not have caused Instructor Treep any trouble, Squall.
No.
Are you really looking out for Instructor Treep? I know! You know?
She's literally right in this room.
Does Danny need to yell? I'm right in front of you.
I'm
so... Also, are we gonna talk about the octopus, or...?
Hold on, guys. Renoa, we agreed in the previous part never to talk about that anymore. Anyway,
it was right there.
So far we've been knocked out 0 times, and Instructor Treep has been knocked out 0. That's right, this girl will be counting how many times you and Quistis have been knocked out in battle.
How have you been able to see all of my fights?
I'm a stalker.
Yeah, they know.
Jeez, you must be the best seed agent there is, because none of us noticed you the entire time.
I can just picture
Dr.
Trap fighting for you.
Oh my god, she's writing her Squall and Quistis fanfiction.
And then they kissed.
Don't shift your teacher and fellow pupils.
No, Shiroi, remember, we've already established this. She's not a teacher anymore.
Actually, hold on. I'm pretty sure she said she wasn't Squall. Well, what she meant was that
she's not Squall's teacher, but she's still a teacher.
Instructor Trap has defeated 6 enemies, and I had such an innocent image of her. You defeated 56 enemies. Why do I even care about you?
Well, screw you too.
I'm gonna tell you
all this information about you and then question why I give a shit.
Actually, Jova, what Quistis told us in the secret area is that she stopped being a teacher to become a full-blown seed, so according to her, she's not even a teacher, period.
My guess is like, oh, she was just trying to say that to get with Squall, but in reality, when that didn't work, she just... I really don't think it's clear, honestly.
Just like
he's approaching the garden.
Is that Master Sid here? Jova, it's like the story lacks clarity and explanations or something. Go ahead.
That's what I've been saying this whole time. No, he's not here. Are you from Balgalbadia?
We are seeds. This is Idea's ship. We are Sorceress Idea's seed.
That makes literally no sense.
We're coming aboard. We're unharmed.
Maybe you should call it a request.
We come in peace.
Jump time. Squall actually had the right idea.
We come in peace.
Then you should have actually requested instead of just saying when you were coming aboard. Peace. Damn it.
We must speak to Headmaster Sid. Where is he?
He's not here. On this port.
I'm right here.
Oh, now he's here.
Oh, never mind.
Hi, Dick.
Headmaster, we've come for alone. It's too dangerous here now.
Oh, but who is this alone person?
Yes, I'm afraid so. Well, we already know thanks to the flashbacks with Laguna too, to be fair.
And that sequence in the training facility.
The little girl
that Laguna was taking care of, remember? The one that wanted Laguna to marry Rain. Anyway, Squall, you know who she is?
Well, yes and no. It's very complicated and very trippy.
Please go find her. She's here somewhere in the garden. Why don't you go get her, you lazy ass?
Or here's the better thing. You know, you're the headmaster. Use that fucking megaphone in the school and actually request her to come here.
Not just that. Again, this is none of the Squall's concern. Why does Squall have to go get her?
Because he's the seed.
Protagonist, please get her.
Fine.
Sure, Sid. You want Squall to wipe your ass while he's at it? I mean, seriously.
Yes, MC hey, Protag.
Pedro, don't tempt him. Sid's been enough of a dick already that he probably would ask Squall to do that.
If it wasn't for 13 Sid, this would be the worst Sid.
I feel like there's another Sid that people don't really like, but I'm drawing a blank.
There are a lot of Sids in this series.
Well, it's one
per chapter.
The common thing with Final Fantasy series is that every game has his own Sid, which is always his own unique character in every game. In the same way that we always have the Biggs and Wedge, like we have in 7 and now in 8. So it's kind of a running thing that the series has, basically. Shirai, please.
Hey, Squall. Who's Zelone?
She's a person in the dream.
I don't know how to pronounce Shiroi, but I've always pronounced it Alone, so just say Alone.
Alone, okay.
It's weird. In my country, she has like an I, like it's called Elion. I don't know.
A person in the dream.
Let me get on the wiki in the meantime. Why not?
Sure, go ahead. And that's all Serena wanted to. I guess Squall's answer was satisfactory enough. All right, Shiroi and Jova, the stage is all yours.
Also, if I'm trivia in the library, you can actually
prepare yourself because we're about to run into the mother of all coinky dinks.
Yeah.
That's Shiroi.
Yes, Squall.
This is the little girl, now fully grown up.
Are you alone?
No, I'm Barbara. What do you think?
No, you're here. I'm not alone.
Ha 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 ha! Funny.
I run into all the comedians in this job. You're alone. The alone.
Well, it's not like anybody. Well, it's not like anybody in this game has last names unless you read the manual. Or the wiki.
What is going
well,
on?
Well, Alone actually doesn't actually have the last name. Oh, she technically does have a last name, but we don't know yet.
You know Laguna, don't you?
I do. I really love Uncle Laguna.
There you go, see? She's the little girl from flashbacks.
Did you ever call him Uncle Lasagna? Because his name's close enough to that.
No, it's not.
This is important. Go ahead.
Then tell me, what is it that we experience?
Bad dreams.
I'm sorry, Squall. It's all true.
Oh no! No, you're going to explain. I don't care. I don't care how hard it is. Explain that shit right now, Missy.
Yes, we are going to have a nice, tightly knit conversation of clarity for once in this story, and you are gonna give it to me.
Also,
so
Squall,
sit down, story master. It's story
also,
time.
Also, Squall caught a fish sometimes this big.
Go ahead. Sure.
No, one second.
Well, whatever. It works.
It's about the past.
Well, yeah, we figured that out already on our own by putting one and one together, honey. Could you be a bit more specific?
It's about yesterday. I was the one who took a dump in your dinner. I'm sorry.
So we were viewing the past.
Quite perceptive, aren't you, Squall?
People say you can't change the past.
But no, if you change the future,
you change the past!
Did Katarzy have anything to do with that bit?
Yes, he's the producer. He was the producer of the 13 trilogy, Dwibs. Yes. Go ahead.
But even still, there's a possibility. It's worth a try, right?
Keep that in mind. Hold on.
Ripple effects.
Not just that, too. Hold on, I'll get to it. But that is true to the thing too, Teo, but what concerns me more is the same thing that also concerns Spoonie when he got to this point.
What am I getting dragged into?
Well, Squall, you've been dragged into things since this game started. I mean, at this point, it's kind of the status quo.
But I feel like I feel like I should draw the line at possibly messing with the time stream continuum.
True, that is true. But yeah, go ahead.
Change the past? Is she serious? Give me a break.
Why would you take you back to the past?
And I just got done talking to an octopus. Are you the one responsible? Are you the one taking us to that dream world? Suddenly I'm doing the closest thing to yelling that I do at this point.
No, no, Drova. It's like a Prince of Persia, where we did Ice Boulder with generic rage.
Yep.
Although, I'd still take this over Warrior Within.
No, I was more referencing just the quote.
Not again. So much I don't understand.
You and me, buddy.
Maybe if you let people explain to you, Squall.
Guys, don't you see? We're in Squall's shoes. It's immersive that we are confused by the story.
Why me? Go ahead.
I have enough problems as it is. Don't get me involved in this.
You're the chosen one.
Okay. No, I actually agree with Squall here. Yeah, I don't think. Yeah.
I'm sorry. Again.
Is that all you can say? I'm sorry.
Sorry, Squall. Fate chose to dick around with you.
Come in, Asai. But,
I think, okay, here's again the thing. It just doesn't feel natural how Squall and the other characters are sort of, well, shoehorned in as the main hero.
I guess Squall lost his balance.
On me.
He's having a bit of a breakdown.
Sure, what are you doing here?
Squall. Did you find Alone?
She's right there!
Shu, try looking to your left. See what happens.
Just a reminder, guys. Shu is one of the highest ranking seeds that there is.
Is anyone in this school having a fucking brain cell?
Shirai.
I'm Alone?
No, Squall's right over there. So
Not this actually looks like a comedy of errors.
You already made that joke.
Is this an Abbott and Costello routine?
You know, it's at this point where I, Squall Leonhart, just have to ask, why the hell is Alone just randomly here at the school anyway? Is the plot just literally falling into my lap now?
Are you alright?
No, he's not.
Alright.
Nothing about this is okay.
Let's see, okay. So, some of my friends may be literally dead. I just found out that our school is funded by a giant talking octopus, and now I figure out that I'm being forced to be the chosen one against my own will. I'm on freaking cloud nine!
Count to ten.
What Alone said under her breath was, okay, audience, you listening?
That's what she said.
You listening, audience? I'm about to tell you what she said
the
under her breath.
Screen has decided to...
You're my only hope.
Of course,
help me, Squall. You're my only hope.
Final Fantasy really cannot stop referencing Star Wars.
Nope.
You can just resist.
Well, to be honest, at this point, it's kind of...
Hold on.
Let Squall monologue. Go ahead.
Sorry.
In the end, you're on your own. I've made it this far by myself. Never mind the fact that I had help.
Because in the end, it doesn't really matter.
Seriously,
I feel like I've been singing this a lot lately.
This is a fucking Linkin Park song lyric.
It was 1999. This kind of plot was all over.
That's exactly.
I couldn't do a thing when I was a kid.
That's what Squall is, Shiroi. He's your typical Linkin Park edgelord teenager fanboy. So.
I've depended on others, but...
Bye!
We're just gonna let you go to Edea, the bad guy of the plot!
See you alone! Bye!
Thanks for all the fish.
But nobody explained anything.
Nope.
I'll be the first one to admit that I'm here because of other people. Okay, so can I just talk about how nonchalant the characters are treating the fact that Alone, the one possible clue they have to everything, is just going to the bad guy? Like, I know that the bad guy is Sid's wife, but still, we've seen that Adea is not a nice person at the moment. I'm fine by myself now. I have all the skills I need to survive. I'm not a child anymore.
So you're not a little boy like Cypher is.
That's a lie. I don't know anything. I'm confused. God help me.
Getting the fucking robot call.
I don't want to defend on anyone. How can I do that?
Oh, boo hoo hoo. Oh, jeez. Yeah, I know, right?
Worn out faces.
Let him mull this over. Come on.
Tell me.
Someone tell me.
Someone.
Somebody
said, Squall, yes, Squall, and guess what? That's okay.
These sound like discount lyrics. These sound like rejected lyrics from that song.
Dweebza, you're the Red Dwarf fan. I sent you a trope of it as a Red Dwarf quote appropriate to this, so please go ahead.
Was this written by a 12-year-old?
Wait, hold on.
Okay, here we go. Stop your foul whining, you filthy piece of distended rectum!
There you go.
Java, your Luke voice, please.
Sis.
Wait, all British and everything?
Okay. No, without the British, obviously.
Evan, or is that also British?
No, Evan is also British.
Oh, okay. I think you mean my Oliver voice.
Sure, go your Oliver voice, yeah.
But I'm doing my best. I'll be okay without you, sis. And now you know why Squall doesn't want to depend on everyone, because his sister died.
More like left him, but
I'll
yeah.
I'll be able to take care of myself, but don't you see, to him, she's dead.
You probably have pneumonia by now.
And that's it, that's Squall's backstory. Hope you enjoyed it.
Okay, Rinoa, knock the fucking door. Seriously, there's some manners. Jesus.
Why are you spying on me?
Myself in.
Are you spying on me, okay, Rinoa? I think you and I need to see other people.
Wait, we were seeing each other? I wasn't asleep.
Yes, we were.
When did that happen?
Go ahead, Shirei.
Oh, really? I think I heard you talking in your
Jesus
sleep.
Jesus Christ,
Rinoa. I'm gonna need you, Rinoa. I'm gonna need you to go away and never talk to me again. Go away.
I'm not telling you what you said.
Oh, see.
Oh, thanks. Just
look at her arms movement. It's so weird.
Oh God, Rinoa, you're a contortionist. Dear Lord, her arms. What's going on with her arms?
I don't know.
She's showing you how flexible she can be.
Oh my.
Oh my. Oh my. Anyway, go ahead.
Hey, let's go for a walk.
Oh my God.
How about no?
We'll stay inside. We're all good at that at this point.
I'm not going anywhere with you, you creepy, stupid stalker.
Okay, so imagine if we didn't bring...
Squall's brought it up again.
Imagine if we didn't bring Rinoa with us, guys. Then we would have never have gotten all the wonderful bits about her wanting to take us on a walk.
Pretty much.
Just go by yourself. It's safe here.
Get the hint, Rinoa.
Please.
It's not that I want a guard with me.
Well, of course I know. You're not. It's not like you're heir for something.
I feel like she had her reasons.
Yes, she did.
You know?
Why are you face-palming?
No. That's supposed to be her way of looking like she's laughing, I think.
Is it?
It's hard to tell because of the way she's standing.
Yeah.
The wonders of advancements in video game graphics. Enough to give us full-body modeled,
people
but
thought
still
these
not
were
quite enough to
That's
convey
point.
What exactly you know, characters were doing always.
You know, if they did a 7 remake S...
Oh, I forgot.
Why don't you lighten up a little?
That'd be an improvement.
I forgot this line, otherwise I would have asked you, Pedro, to get that Linkara quote that he says reading Batman. Lighten up a little, will ya? You look positively grim.
Yeah, you
true.
Know when Batman of all people
bad,
is telling
worry.
You that.
Just smile.
Oh.
It's not good to think too much. I mean,
you know what? Maybe
clearly, the primary philosophy behind the writing of this script.
You know what?
Clearly.
Sometimes it's best not to think too much, alright? And this plot is one of them.
Hey, at least for now, I don't have to worry too much about thinking. So
what I'm trying to say is...
Okay, so get to the point, Rinoa. What is it?
It would be my honor.
Wait, aren't you going to take me out to dinner first?
to have your company. Your what?
Highness?
She's patronizing him.
I hope that I may get your mind off things.
Okay, I get what you're trying to do.
Get your mind onto other things.
I get what
you're trying to do. Now, try not to be a condescending prick.
I get, okay, maybe. Okay, that too, but go ahead.
How about it, your highness?
Yeah, please pick the second option, please. Oh, goddammit.
Fine. Alright, let's do it.
Thank you, your high. Okay, stop.
You are so. Okay, okay, you are okay, such okay, a we, terrible remember, person, you know that.
It happened already with Cypress. Squall is not into roleplay. Come
alarm,
on.
Go ahead.
This is actually her foreplay.
Alright.
Like, I mean, it's incredibly awkward, but, you know, I get the feeling that she has not had to really try that hard with
all
her
right.
boyfriends.
Allow me. Point. I get what the writers are trying to convey with this. You know, she really can't stand seeing Squall so, you know, looking so sad and whatever. She wants her best to try to cheer him up. I get that. That's fine. But again, like Jova would say, the way it's worded and executed, it's so terrible. Why is the stalking angle even there? For
this
one.
It's like I said, it's Final Fantasy VIII in a nutshell. It definitely has good intentions. The problem is that those intentions get portrayed or conveyed so terribly that, well,
they come
your
across
mind
as bad intentions.
Well be in the gutter.
Yeah, they come across it's good intentions turned into bad intentions because of the worst delivery possible.
Oh boy, this scene.
Boy, it's
a slow day.
Go, Dwarves can be this fisherman. Why not? Go ahead.
Come on, give me a big one.
Monkey's paw.
Oh boy, we're gonna crash again.
You wanted a big one.
And guess what? The reason for this is because Sid doesn't know how to pilot the garden. What good are you? You fucking useless.
I got something.
Dibs, yes. What's like a good British insult I can apply to this guy?
Wanker.
Okay.
Wanker. Yeah. You're a fucking useless wanker. Like,
yeah, so, someone clearly liked the Roland Emmerich Godzilla movie.
Squall, this is Headmaster speaking. Please come to my office and do this shit for me. Thanks, KFX.
Did you crash the garden again?
Repeat, please come to my office right away. I can't
Am
do anything
I the
because...
the only student who gets anything done here?
Apparently, yeah. Seriously, why are they?
You know. I'll just say this, and people wonder why Squall has issues. I'll just say this. I think it's kind of apparent why Squall has issues.
Okay, Jova.
Nobody is helping that.
Well, Jova, that's good. We found out the explanation for his issues, but the explanation opened up a whole other issue of problems. So
yes, it does.
Ah, Squall.
God help him.
Ah, Squall. Thank you for coming.
Not like I had any other choice, asshole.
Here are your orders.
Tell them how sorry you are for crashing
okay.
the ship.
We've landed on fishermen's around. Well, more like we crashed, but whatever. Please go ashore. Please go ashore with Chrysis and Renoa.
Okay. That sounds relatively simple for once.
Well, I'm not done, am I?
There's a catch, of course.
Find the local mayor and apologize for this accident. Tell them that we come in peace. Yeah.
It was
Why
your fault. Go
do
apologize
I
yourself.
Have to apologize.
I know, right? Thanks, Dwibs. Take a look around the city while you're there, too.
By the way, that comment I made earlier about you must go and apologize for the accident you caused, I did it as Sid. I was joking.
Why do I have to go? Can't I just rest
for once? Why can't Sid even send like a letter that says he's apologizing, spoilers, just to be the delivery boy?
This is an explanation. This is an explanation. Sid is not just a special force for combat. I want you to see the world, to broaden your horizons. I have access. Fuck off! That's the worst excuse I ever heard. No, you just made that shit up, and you know it.
That would be commendable if the world wasn't so boring in this
setting. Okay. You know what? Maybe if they were going with the plot twist that Sid is actually Squall's father, and this is just his weird way of parenting, you know, Squall being what he thought to be an orphan didn't know that, I could maybe get it. But I'll let you know, that's not what they're going with here.
Nope. I don't think Sid and Eddie ever had any kids, period, anyway, so.
Well, honestly, Pedro, I'll be honest, the first time I played this game, I thought that's what they were going with at this point, because it would have made sense why Sid was, you know, constantly calling on Squall to do the stuff for, you know, so talk about how he wanted Squall to see the world or and whatnot. You know, it seemed like, you know, maybe it was his point to try and get Squall, you know, have another try at being the father that Squall didn't have, literally.
Yep.
But alas. I mean, come on, you gotta admit, that would have at least given Sid more motivation for half of his actions.
Well, Jova, but like I've said various times, we can only talk about what-ifs for as much as we can. I mean, at the end of the day, we have to evaluate what's here, not what it could have been. So, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right. It's like the whole thing with Sonic. It's like the thing with Sonic. Oh, what it could have been. Well, we're not talking about what it could have been. We're talking about what it is. But anyway, yeah. Basically, let's go. Because Sid is a fucking useless wanker that can't do anything right. We have to do this shit for him. We've come to warn you before you go ashore.
Oh boy.
Now what?
Do not engage in any type of armed conflict in the city. We do not tolerate belligerence here. Basically, no violence of any kind is allowed in this city. Basically, arms whatsoever.
That's literally all they have to say to people who literally crashed onto their harbor?
No violence.
I'm actually surprised. Normally you would expect something like, I expect to see a parking certification for that thing, or... You know, something like pay us up for the damages, but no, they're
welcome to Fisherman's Horizon. We just call it FH. Debs, you can be the guy on the back. Go ahead.
You should go visit the mayor. His house is in the middle of the city.
Okay.
Of course it is.
As for you two, you can be the head of this city. Why not?
Okay.
The mayor.
He's the head of F.
We'll do just that. Maybe for once I will have a
Fisherman Horizon is actually quite big as a place, and there's a lot of things to do, but most of them are kind of pointless, and there will be more stuff to do only later. Mm-hmm. But hold on.
Man, this is a hell of a mess.
I'm terribly sorry for my... It was inevitable. We lost control of the garden.
Nobody had control of it in the first place.
Nah, don't worry about it. What's important is that nobody got hurt. Huh, surprisingly.
Something Jurassic Park.
Surprisingly.
What about that fisherman earlier?
Nah, it's okay.
He jumped into the water, so he's A-okay.
Well, he died.
Yes.
We love fixing stuff anyway. So now you gave us something to occupy our time with.
Wow, can you imagine? Oh no, you broke my most prized possession. But I love fixing stuff, so thank you.
Hey, they're resourceful.
Kick back and enjoy your stay. Bye.
Alright, in the meantime, I checked. Yes, in my specifically, it seems to be just in my country. Elon has an I in it, which is pronounced instead Elion. I don't know. Maybe it's because it's the actual potential name. Because Elon, the etymology on the wiki says that Elon might be derived from Elona. Elon is a variant of Hebrew Alona and Hungarian and Greek Ilona. It means oak tree and light.
So
there's literally that.
So basically, Elon then. Yeah. Not that it matters. Maybe one day, if like Dweb said, maybe we get a FF7 remake-ish thing of this game, which I doubt we will, but maybe we'll see.
Well, I mean, to be fair, this game does have its fan base, so...
True, but not to the size of 7. Hell, I actually think 9 nowadays is a bigger... a chance of getting that than 8 does.
And that is interesting. Basically, Shireen Dreams, back in the day, Final Fantasy VIII was a big, massive seller.
Oh, it was!
People
loved this game back in the day.
And believe it or not, there was a time when this game was definitively more popular than Final Fantasy IX, though I think eventually there came a bit of a paradigm shift, no pun intended.
Yeah, there was, yes.
Where Final Fantasy IX started to become more popular.
And 8 is kind of that game that... Oh, yeah, that one. Go ahead.
The more had nothing to do with 9 anyway, so...
No.
Let me get someone else to remake 9.
Maybe Reiki Ito. I don't know what he's doing right now, because we know he's still at Square, we just don't know what he's doing.
I will say this, though. Final Fantasy VIII could be a case where, hey, let's remake a lesser game to be an actually great game. You know, I mean, and you know what? It can work, as we saw with stuff like Castlevania Adventures being remade for the eShop on the Wii, essentially.
In the meantime, Familiar Face 2 has
face
a...
Number 3.
Familiar Face number 3 is an exact clone, duplicate, of Familiar Face 2. So, nice to see that the people of Fisherman Horizons figure out the secret of cloning.
Of course.
Never mind, the way you live your life is none of my business. Just don't cause us any problems.
It's for a just cause.
Go ahead, Joe.
He sounds just like me. I guess it doesn't sound very nice.
Gee, some self-reflection finally.
Literally. Good God, I may be having an existential crisis. Which is probably the least of my mental issues right now.
I guess. Alright. So yeah, the boss of this city lives at the very center of this...
Solar dish!
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty much a solar dish.
What an interesting... The architect must have had a ball designing this crap.
I'll just say this. Hopefully they don't go the way of Terra Grisha, ATO.
Uh-huh.
Alright, if I remember now, it's the... Yeah. Oh, no, never mind.
What a curious home.
Alright, I'll be the...
Is anyone staying here?
Alright, I'll be the lady, and Tear will be the boss, the guy who's...
Oh, boy.
The guy who looks like, I don't even know what this...
Please, have a seat.
Where's there to sit?
You need to, like, stand there, man. Squall, seat, not kneel!
I refuse!
Allow me to get to the point. Where...
No one knows how to sit in the
allow me to get to the point. Can you get the fuck out of my CD?
It's not wasting any time. We'll leave as soon as the garden is capable of moving.
Well, shit. Any idea when?
Maybe a month? I'm afraid not. We only discovered that our garden is mobile a short while ago. God,
okay,
that sounds
the
embarrassing when
is...
I say it out loud.
They're so disproportionate. Yeah, Squall looks...
Imposing.
Huge. Gigantic.
Our technicians will assist you. They should be able to repair and service everything.
Wow, this
he's
guy,
not that tall.
Wow, this guy really wants us to leave. I find that suspicious.
How's that sound?
That means we'll have to let outsiders on to the garden. I can't make this decision alone.
Go consult with your leader if you don't have authority or whatever.
Well, to be fair,
I don't care. Back to the pot.
Is she right?
Excuse me, why do you want us to leave so
Renoa,
bad?
Shut the fuck up and let's Squall do Reno- the talking.
Why?
Renoa, don't, no talking. We talked
they
about-
haven't told us why, though.
I mean, Reno I can't imagine.
Renoa is that kind of character that, you know, you want to be left alone and she's just poking you with a stick all the time.
Hey, hey, listen.
Please keep your mouth shut.
Thank you!
Okay. Renoa, this is Squall speaking here. Maybe, just maybe...
We don't want military organizations in FH. You rely on force to solve problems, and, you know, we want to be with the spirits, man. That is the right defiance of our principle. You gotta be with the fishes and the wind.
We believe that any problem can be settled by discussion. Why am I called Flo?
Because you go with the flow of things.
If you reach a mutual understanding, there is no need to fight.
Just flow with the live stream in the air, man.
You just got a vibe.
There, Triton dull as hell, though.
Oh,
I'd rather we solve our problems with violence!
Violence only leads to more violence, but in the end, it has to be this way.
Did Neil Druckmann take over this bit? Like,
I knew you were going
we believe our presence here will attract violence. That's why we want you to leave us. Not just that, it's also
Mere
similar to
violence.
It's also similar to Crescendo and Serenade in Eternal Sonata. A lot of game developers, even storytellers in general, has this obsession of painting people who want to something diplomacy as the most, as either cowards, idiots, or completely out of touch with reality, and that's fucking stupid.
Yeah.
Look, I get it that history showcased that Chamberlain was kind of an idiot and Churchill wasn't the necessary thing against people like Hitler, but come on, that shouldn't, rule out the idea that having a diplomatic type of society is a, it's not a good thing.
Gosh, that was unpleasant. I know.
You know, right?
Telling me, Questus.
Did I miss something?
Forget it. You can't expect everyone to welcome us, especially considering how we crashed literally into their town.
Also, violence doesn't necessarily lead to more violence.
Exactly.
Galvanian soldier. It's complicated and sadly needs to be reserved for another time because Galvania is arriving.
Great.
Oh.
Wait, and how the hell did I get here so fast?
Yeah, she's an old
lady. You have good access.
The Galvanians are here because of you, right? They're after you.
Yes, we get it. It's our fault, maybe.
You'd better take full responsibility. It's your fault.
I cannot get a break today. Fine, we'll take care of them. I don't like the sound of her tone, though.
Come on, Squall, say it. How can things get any worse?
Well, you were trying to have a break, but Renoa was spying on you again, like the creepy, creepy bitch.
Go ahead, Teo.
Sorry, we mustn't rely on violence, man.
Don't tell me he's going to try to reason with them.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. The mayor is going to try to solve this problem by just talking to the Galbadian army.
Go talk to them. I'm sure nothing wrong will come out of this.
Brilliant!
He's dead.
You see,
they're probably going to ask to hand you over.
Little did you...
Alright.
You see... Hold on.
I think I've...
Go ahead.
Okay, guys, I think I've got it. How do you think the mayor is going to be killed? Shot to the head? Stabbed.
Shot. Galbadian prefer a type of firearm and being cut.
So basically what this game is telling me is that in all the various times that Spain tried to take back our country for themselves, all we had to do was just send an old man and deploy and, talk to them and convince them, nah guys, just don't, man. Violence is raw, man, and that will solve the problem.
Raw bros here.
Totally.
Kitaze, did you do any research? Do you know anything about how history worked?
No, because again, it's clear that the game is trying to make a point that, these people are idiots, because the situation is clearly not suited for everyone, which, yes, it is true. But it's so uncharacteristic to have, people with this type of morality doing illogical things just to uphold to their morals.
Yeah. Get on. So, basically, we're supposed... Okay, so, let's... this is me showing... is something wrong?
Oh, just everything. About everything.
Yeah.
Literally,
and that's it. I wanted to show that. That's the thing. Basically, I figured I would show that because it's interesting. Because
all you can tell, Sid.
Remember, we were supposed to kind of talk to Sid before this happened. So it's kind of interesting that the game kind of forgets about the whole go talk to Sid thing. So
not only that, but regardless of whether or not it forgot about the whole talk to Sid thing, shouldn't you have more dialogue to share with Sid, considering? Literally everything that is going on.
I don't. That's again, like I said, like what was that line again about the thinking that we saw in this game? What was the line again?
Just don't think.
No. The game itself in this part had a natural line.
Yeah, Reno did mention it. Sometimes it's best not to want to think too much about things.
Yeah, again, clearly the primary philosophy that Jim and Kitaze used when writing this.
I argue it was the opposite. They thought a bit too much about the segment. They thought it was a great idea.
Yeah, I mean, it's like I said, it's the game constantly trying to overcomplicate stuff that doesn't need to be so complicated, and then they end up with Bubkiss for an actual meaning.
Yeah, we've been roaming around in circles plot-wise for 2.5 discs, and what do we have to show for it, exactly?
Well, Selphie, Irvine, and Zell are dead.
Well, we can't show.
Saying that, like, you're saying that like it's a bad thing, Joe.
I don't know. I prefer Irvine over Rinoa personally.
I guess, but I deem this needs a total party kill. So free down, free to go.
See ya, everybody.
Okay then.
See ya.
See ya.